Welcome to the video. My name is Sayed. Greetings. Let's get started. So in this video, we will cover how to create party invitation on Google Form and how to keep track of your guest list. So first thing is we need to go to the drive.google.com in order to create a Google Form. So we are in our Google Drive. You have to click on this new button up here on the left hand side on the top of the corner. New and scroll down to the Google Form up here. We can create in two different ways. We can create it from the blank form and we can create from the template. Since it's a party invite, let's take a look at it, a Google template that we can use and leverage. So there's Google already have a party invite, which is I have changed a bit. So let's take a look at it. And also that is some of the party invite. There are different templates available. Assessment, RSVP. If I scroll down up here, you can see more event related registration. You can select that. So I'm going to select party invite. And in that, that is default party invite from Google. Google already made that. You can change pictures up here. You can change the title, description. This is only just a sample from Google, and you can say you can change these questions as well. So let's take a look at it. So how to do that? So if I go to the party invite, so if I can say for birthday. Let's say if we can do that, and I can click up here on pair to customize the theme. I can click up here. So now you can see colors are coming. If I want to select green theme, now it is green. You can select different colors up here. Background color, you can change it. And basic color too, you can change the font type. It is more playful, let's say. So these are the changes you can select, and also you can image upload to change this the background thing up here. And so this is for the theme. Question you can change. You can change the description, name. There is there. If you want to see, if you want to add more question, you can click on this plus sign, and it will bring a question. So if I press a plus sign up here, it will bring a question right below it. Let's take a look at it. So if I say plus sign, and if I write email address, so that will bring automatically the option for that. You can select different type of answers up here. So let's delete this up here. So what is your name? Can you attend? So that is a question. How many attending? So let's add one more thing up here, your phone number, let's say name, and then we can say phone number. Let's add one more time, let's say if we want to select the time. So these are the questions you can add or change and update. You can create from the scratch, from the none of these questions will be there. So we just added few questions up here, and let's take a look at it. Would you be bringing something up here? Do you have any allergy or diet? So these questions are there, and you can make some questions are mandatory. Let's say your name have to be required. You have to answer that. Let's take a look at it. Can you attend? Let's make it required. So these two questions are required in this party invite. So let's make it available for other people to see how you can send this. After you completed all of this, your Google Form update, you can click on send up here on the right hand side on the corner on top. So send, you have a different options. You can copy paste all of your email address and it will go to them directly. You can select the link, copy the link and send them that. So there's a copy button up here. You can click on this shorter link. So you have a shorter link up here instead of that long link. And also you can embed this in your website. So you can select this code and put this code in your HTML code on your website. So that will, and you can adjust this height and width and height on your website. So that will bring some proportionate information. You can set up how you want to see this on your website. If it is too high up here, if it is too wide, you can make it smaller, you can make it bigger. So that will appear. And also you can select this share via Facebook and Twitter as well. And you can select collect emails. If you want to select emails, you can collect that as well. So that is basically it for the link. Let's take a look at the link option up here, shorter link, copy. And I'm going to close this up here and open a new tab up here and paste this link up here. And this link will open up that birthday invite for party for invite. So that is email is showing up here, my email address, and this form I can select. So let's say if I want to select test 2223224. What time you can attend? Let's say PM. Yes. And let's say two people, valid, submit. After you submit this form, you have an option of edit your response after as the person who is invited. So I'm going to close this up here and go back to this up here. So as we can see that you can track of your customers, your guest up here by going to the responses. And you can see the responses you have up here. And you can see the name of the person. So all of the new people who will be submitting this, you can see their responses up here. And so let's go to settings and take a look at one more option up here. So responses. So allow response editing. After that, they can edit this and limit one person. So I'm going to change this to just to show you that I want to see that how the responses look and the all the information appears. So let's go to the questions up here, and I'm going to put this again, the link thing up here, Google form. And since I just changed the option, so I'm going to say test 2, phone number is 223 1234. I'm just making these numbers up. 06 00. I'm going to select no this time. And how many are attending? So none of them are attending, so just submit. So let's close this. Let's enter one more entry. So just have a take a look at it, how it is looking. So your name is James. Your phone number is 1 2 3 6. Yes. And how many are attending? 2. So let's just submit this form up here again. Since we have 3 entries up here, it should show 3 responses now. We can see the who are attending test 1, test 2, and James. Their phone numbers are here. And you can see the timing. I just did not update the timing up here. So you can see that 33%. So it's showing you the graph and all the name of the persons and everything on there. So that way you can keep track of your guest. And you can also maintain them in Excel file. If you create a spreadsheet, you will have a response list in your spreadsheet. And it is in your Google Drive. So I hope this video helped you. And if you have any more questions, and if you like to add more comments to this video, please go ahead. And if you like to see any other video related to this topic, please let me know. I can consider that to have another video made based on that. So Thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, and leave a comment and feedback. Thank you very much.